Never again. That's the last time I go on a pub crawl.
It's your fault for inviting Princess Margaret. Only yourself to blame. He had his stag night last night. I told you you'd wake up with a sore head, and I wasn't wrong.
Just keep your voice down, all right?
I don't feel too clever myself. I don't know what we ended up doing last night, but I've just found a packet of condoms and a return ticket to Whipsnade in my coat pocket.
Blimey, what a night. You behaved outrageously.
I don't remember a thing.
Oh, well, let me remind you. Not only did you drop your trousers in the reptile house, but you were seen climbing into the polar bear enclosure, shouting, "Come on, Blondie, you know you'll like it."
No, I never did. Mind you, that could explain the white fur in my Calvin Klein's. I was going to take them back. Shouldn't you be getting ready?
What for?
Well, rumour has it you're getting married this afternoon.
Oh, I knew I'd forgotten something.
You remember WPC Reen, the woman of your dreams, Beau Derek with a truncheon?
I'll have to get rid of this hangover first.
Well, I've only ever had a hangover once before. And that was after my West End opening. And I... Hurry along. I perked myself up with the following concoction. Welcome to Julian's Tasty Tips. An occasional feature that finds me bent over a baby belling with a funnel in one hand and an icing bag in the other. Now, before I go any further and impart to you my culinary expertise, I will need someone to fluff up my meringues. Oh, Terry.
Oh, no.
You ever operated a juicer before? Perhaps you have. Let's look at your hands. Spotless. Now, I'm going to be a sort of new age Fanny Craddock. We want you to be my Johnny. What? Now, hangovers. When you wake up with something throbbing on your forehead, thank the Lord and get on with it. You know, that is time. It's time for a pick-me-up. Now, the following recipe is simple and effective and goes down like my friend Damien. What you'll need are the following ingredients. You'll need a couple of eggs in the bowl, including the shell. That gives a bit of roughage. Some curry paste. Some powdered mustard. Powdered vindaloo. Black pepper. Tabasco. And salt to taste. Mix all these up in your bowl, put them into the shaker. Mix them up thoroughly, would you please, Johnny? Could you hum something for me like they do on these programs? A sort of jolly cookery tune? Give it a good shake. Come on, you can do better than that, surely. Just imagine you're at home by yourself. The curtains are drawn. Sarah Green's on the telly. Your trousers around your ankles. And you'll find that your hangover disappears quicker than you can say Philip Schofield.
I'll try anything.
Terry, you're not supposed to drink it.
What? What's the matter?
You're supposed to apply it externally.
I'll go outside and drink it.
Are you feeling queasy?
No, not a bit. I feel much better. In fact, I can't ever remember feeling this good before.
Terry, sit yourself down.
Oh, no, I want to dance. I want to climb any mountain, ford any cortina. I want to lead a crocodile of young children through the German lines.
He thinks he's Julie Andrews.
Just a spoonful of saccharin helps the mescaline go.
Ah! What's the matter, Terry?
It's the pain.
Where is it?
It's in my arms. Oh, no! It's in my legs. It's in my chest. Hey, It's moving around.
That's what I'll say.
It's a stabbing, squeezing, tightening sensation.
Oh, I know people who pay good money for that.
It's like a steel band across my chest.
I once had a brass band round my waist.
I'm slipping up. Tell Reenie she's the only woman I ever loved. Well, the only woman who had her own teeth.
Don't go, Terry.
Yeah, I am.
Don't go.
I can see my life flashing before my eyes.
Am I in it yet? Obviously. Well, I think what we need is a doctor.
Stand back. Now, what appears to be the trouble?
Well, I don't feel very well.
I'll be the judge of that. First things first. Say Booper. Say Nanette Newman. This man's very sick indeed. Acute appendicitis.
Then I must operate at once. I'll just get my marigolds. You get him to the hospital. Now, before we proceed with this particular scene, I will need an assistant from the audience. The qualifications for this job are: you must be spotlessly clean, not afraid of the sight of blood, and hold the sexual charisma of a rutting stag. Are you volunteering, Mayor? What's your name? Paul? Well, I'll look no further then. Paul, ladies and gentlemen. How do you do, Paul? Shake both hands. What do you do for a living normally?
Barber.
You're a barber? Oh, well, that's down the same avenue, isn't it? We're just going to dress you up here. Just cutting hair, morning, noon and night. Well, now, come and stand here. What I want you to do is pass me various things. So there's a scalpel there, mm-hmm. Okay, and the stapler, yeah. And so on. So and I also want you to repeat after me. So I'll say scalpel, you say scalpel. Do you follow, Paul?
Yeah.
Okay.